Bizarre things happen near black holes, with clocks slowing down and objects getting ripped apart. All very mind-blowing stuff. Let's take a closer look at some of the weird things that black holes can do. In my last video, I talked a bit about what black holes are and what they aren't, and if you're interested in learning the basics, I recommend you watch that video first. You can find the link to it in the description below. As a quick reminder, a black hole is an object, often with the mass of a bigger star, but with the mass concentrated into tiny size. The gravity near the black hole is very strong, and there is a distance from that small mass where gravity is so strong that not even light can escape. A sphere at that distance is called the event horizon. Outside the event horizon, you can at least potentially escape the black hole. Inside it, you're caught forever. That's the gist of a black hole. Once you get past the question of what a black hole is, the obvious question is, what happens if you fall in one? And that's a good question, with some surprises in the answer, especially since many times the answers you see in books and videos don't carefully lay out some of the assumptions that go into the explanations. So let's look into that. What happens if you drop a small object into a black hole? Well, given that the theory of relativity describes gravity and black holes, it shouldn't surprise you the answer depends on who's asking the question. I mean, we all know that Einstein's special theory of relativity says that two observers who are moving at different speeds will disagree about how fast two clocks tick and how long two objects are. The theory of general relativity includes all that and more. For example, it says that a person freely falling into the black hole along with the object will have a different experience from someone far away and watching the same object fall towards the black hole. Let's start with the simplest situation. Let's drop a small, blinking white light into a black hole. To be specific, the light blinks once per second. What does this object experience as it falls to the center of a black hole? Basically, it's not much different from our familiar expectations of gravity. The object heads towards the center of the black hole. Nothing changes as it passes the event horizon. It just falls faster and faster until it hits the center, blinking away, emitting white light at a rate of once per second. At the moment, I'm not talking about what the object sees as it looks around it, just what it experiences. Now, what does a person see who is far from the black hole and watching the object fall? Well, they see something different. For them, the event horizon profoundly affects what they see. You see, light is affected by gravity, and the light emitted from the object falling into the black hole has to fight its way out of the black hole's gravitational field. In that fight, it loses energy. Different colors of light have different amounts of energy. Blue light has more energy and red light has less. So, if light loses energy, it looks redder than it ordinarily would. Thus, a distant observer sees the light emitted from an object as the object falls into a black hole, getting redder and redder as it approaches the event horizon. Eventually, it gets so red that the light becomes infrared and it fades from view. So that's one thing that happens, but it's not the only thing that happens. Time passes differently in strong gravitational fields than it does in weak ones. Specifically, time passes more slowly as the amount of gravity gets stronger. So our little object that is blinking once per second before we drop it into the black hole begins to blink more slowly. The outside observer sees it takes 2 seconds per blink, then three, and then more. The distant observer sees that each blink takes longer and longer as the object approaches the event horizon. It can get extreme. As the object gets very close to the event horizon, a distant observer can see the time between blinks take 1,000 years, then 1,000,000, and eventually longer than the lifetime of the universe. When we combine the two effects of color change and clock slowing down, what we see as the blinking object falls towards the event horizon is that it gets redder and redder, blinking ever more slowly. Indeed, time slows down so much that an outside observer never sees it fall through the event horizon, and the color of the object goes from red to infrared to radio waves. So that's super bizarre. An outsider never sees an object fall inside the black hole. It gets to the event horizon, seemingly frozen in time and fading into undetectability. Indeed, it's fair to say that a distant observer sees all of the matter that falls into a black hole suspended forever just outside the event horizon, there, but invisible. What I just described sounds crazy, but the effect has been demonstrated here on Earth with super precise clocks. Researchers took two identical clocks and raised one of them a single foot. Since gravity changes slightly with altitude, the higher clock experienced slightly less gravity and ticked faster. It was an awesome experiment, and I put a link in the description to some suggested reading if you're interested. Now, if you're a science buff, you might have heard that getting close to a black hole can tear you apart. I didn't mention any of that, so what's going on? Well, I didn't mention that because in the examples I've discussed so far, I told you that the object was super tiny, and that was very important. But real objects aren't tiny. What happens if an object with a real size falls into a black hole? To understand that, we need to remember that gravity around a star or planet isn't the same everywhere. It gets stronger or weaker depending on how far away you are from it. For example, gravity seems to be the same here on Earth. That's the 9.8 meters per second squared that you might have learned about in a physics class if you've taken one. But gravity changes with altitude. The International Space Station orbits the Earth about 250 miles or about 400 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. Gravity at the altitude of the space station is only about 90% as strong as experienced on the Earth's surface, or about 8.7 meters per second squared for the true physics fans. The same effect is true around the black hole. Gravity gets stronger closer to the center and weaker away from the center. You can see the basic idea here. The lines are gravity radiating away from the black hole. You can sort of think of the lines as the total amount of gravity or something. Where the lines are closely spaced, gravity is stronger, and where they are far apart, gravity is weaker. These red circles kind of drive the point home. The same number of lines go through both circles, but the smaller circle is closer to the center of the black hole, with more closely packed lines and stronger gravity. So now let's add an object, in this case, a simple box. The important thing is that the box has a size, and when we do this, we see that the edge of the box nearest the black hole has more lines going through it than the edge farther away from the black hole. In this case, 5 lines on the bottom and 3 on the top. This means that the gravity tugging the bottom of the box is stronger than the gravity tugging at the top. So, suppose a volunteer was falling feet first into a black hole. His feet would be pulled harder than his head and he would get stretched out. The word scientists use for this is spaghettification, and yes, that's an actual technical word. It's kind of silly, but it's actually pretty appropriate. Now, if we're being honest, he doesn't really get stretched out. What happens is that the force on his feet is so much stronger than his head that he would actually get torn apart. But that's a bit more graphic, and our volunteer here on the screen is such a good-looking guy that I don't want to show that. So, spaghettified he is. Spaghettification is yet another reason why it's silly to talk about entering a black hole. I mean, you can't get out of black holes, and you get torn apart as you fall in. Overall, it's not a great experience. 0 stars. Now, there is one caveat. This spaghettification thing happens when you fall inside a black hole with a mass equal to a few stars. But not all black holes are that size. At the center of galaxies, there are what are called supermassive black holes, with masses equal to millions or even billions of stars. At the center of our Milky Way galaxy, there is a black hole with a mass of about 4 million stars. What happens if you fall into one of those? Well, a black hole with a mass of the size of the one at the center of the Milky Way has a much bigger event horizon than around an ordinary star. Remember that the event horizon around a star with the mass of the Sun has a radius of about 3 kilometers. The event horizon of the Milky Way's supermassive black hole is more like 12 million kilometers. This much bigger size means that even though the gravity exerted near the surface of a galactic black hole is the same as a smaller one, the gravity near a supermassive hole doesn't change as rapidly over short distances. So, for an object the size of a person falling into this supermassive black hole, the force on the head and feet aren't so different. And that means that you don't get torn apart, so no spaghettification if you're falling into a really big black hole. You still can't get outside the hole, and that business about someone seeing you turn red and have your time slow down as you fall in is still true, but at least you don't get ripped apart as you fall towards it. So we've learned a couple of fun facts about falling into black holes, and that's probably a good place to wrap up this video. There's more to learn, and perhaps I'll return to black holes in future episodes. They really are one of the most fascinating of all cosmic phenomena. Okay, so that's another black hole video in the book. If you always wanted to fall in one, but are now thinking maybe you should take it off your bucket list, you're welcome. If you're liking learning about both cosmic and subatomic physics, I hope you'll click that subscribe button down below. And how can you not like learning about these things? It doesn't seem possible. After all, physics is everything.